So it's going to be a complaining, like, confession video, I guess. I feel I have so much to complain about for basically no reason. No reason I can. These 3 free days I had for my own projects, and I so wanted to edit and upload my latest video that I recorded exactly 1 week ago. Really thought I would do that, because I think it's time now to upload a new video for you. You might be waiting for a new video, and I get so many uplifting comments from you, and really nice comments that my videos help you sleep and help you through really hard times, like depression, and it really feels like a good thing to do this ASMR video. I'm a bit hungry. My stomach just rumbled. But it's one of these days when I just don't want to, or I don't have the power to eat, or, you know, drink my beer or anything. Or go out. Actually, I have to go to the library. I have to return this book, How to Think Like a Neanderthal. I don't want to return it already. I have only read half of it. I'm in the middle of it. But I have had it for quite a long time now, a couple of months, and I have renewed the loan, I think twice, so now I can't do it. I have to go back with it, otherwise I will have to pay some fee. I don't know why I stopped in the middle. I really like this book. Or maybe it was because I good job. I get well paid and such things. But you know, somehow I feel, I can see this pattern, that how it makes me feel these days. I know I had to go back. It doesn't feel good. So I guess I don't find it too meaningful, the things I'm doing there. It's well paid. It's an advertising. I don't feel any meaning, I think, in it. Any bigger meaning. Like I do with the videos. The ASMR videos. That feels meaningful to me. So, it's sad that I couldn't work on my video projects this week. Or I have, actually. I've tried. All 3 days I have tried. And I have progressed. I mean, I filmed it 1 week ago. And I have done some minor editing now for 3 days. But it's a lot. I know somewhere that it's not laziness, it's more like connected to anxiety. So I don't know if it's good for anyone to listen to this much complaining. I just thought it would be something different for me to do. A video, but try to turn it to something good instead of just negativity. And I think I'll go back with this one today, so I at least leave the room. After a walk outside in the cold winter day, windy day today, maybe I feel better, maybe I can do some more editing. I think it's just 15 minutes for me to walk to the library. But it's the whole thing of just leaving the room. That's stopping me. When I'm outside the front door, then when you could sleep. I want to tell you a bit about my latest videos. The video I'm talking about that I'm editing, it's a really long video. I think it's now now it's 1 hour and 20 minutes. See if I cut some parts of it, segments down, then maybe it will be a bit shorter at the end. But it's a new drawing video. It's a map drawing video that I really liked. Enjoyed the recording it. It's a bit different from my previous ones. Disturbing things happening while recording it, since it was a really long recording session as well. So there were planes, noises from planes all the time, flying. And there were also a lot of children cheering, like really high pitched shouts. Blame them, but you know, when you have this like glass breaking high pitch yells on the video, maybe that's not the most relaxing thing to listen to for others. And there were also like annoying sounds from my body, like my throat. I drink a lot of coffee. I noticed that my throat starts to make this annoying, unintentional glurring sounds. I call them glurs. I don't know what to call them. So I have a long list of timestamps on the footage that I want to edit. Edit those. At least lower the volume a bit. To me, they're really annoying. I don't want to post a video with those sounds. And then also at the end of the recording, my stomach started to rumble a bit, and maybe I became hungry or something. And those sounds were not pleasant. Sentences I said, like using the English language wrong. Sometimes I just feel really embarrassed about that. I want to like cut that part from the video and try to edit it so it will not be so notable that it's a cut. Video. So I have a long list with things I want to do with that 80 minute footage. And I hoped I could do that during these 3 days, but I just couldn't. But one thing I did yesterday that I hadn't planned at all was actually I went out filming new footage for a outdoor video, and I'm so glad I did that yesterday. I took the chance, even though I didn't feel very well, but it was something else. It hadn't to do with the editing. That was so, that made me so anxious. So it was something new and fresh, and I went out this special day because I thought that this would be the only chance, like maybe for a year. The weather conditions were just perfect for this idea I got. I think I got the idea maybe 3 days ago when I was outside running. It wasn't 3 days ago, it was 4 days ago. Then I got the idea when I was running and heard the sounds from my feet on the ice, on the ground. So I got an idea, and the weather conditions yesterday were just perfect. And they were just perfect. And I filmed for almost 2 hours, maybe. And with the wind. I have actually made a constructed wind screen for my microphone that I can use outside, but it wasn't, it's like three parts in, it's in three layers, and I just used two first layers because I didn't think I had to have this foam top because it wasn't so windy. But when I heard the result, I realized I should have had all these layers. But that was just in the first 5 minutes or something. The rest is really good. And the volume was a bit too loud. Input volume. I should have turned it down a couple of steps, maybe. You just, when you know, it's like a once in a, not a lifetime, but once in a year opportunity, maybe. You can make this kind of video, you just want the conditions, the equipment, and the, yeah, the technical setup to be just perfect. But I think it will be really good, and that will be my next video after this one that I'm not editing. So maybe I will post this video out that I'm recording now instead of the map. I have actually quite a lot of footage now recorded, but I somehow feel editing hard. I used to like editing actually. There are some times some days, like time spans when I enjoy editing. I have to, something with self-confidence, I think. Now I'm in a time when I'm not so many. I think this is the reason. I just lying here all day thinking of reasons and complaining. So this is one reason I've come up with. Stationary? No. Stationary is something else. Stationär. In Swedish we say stationär dator. A stationär dator. A computer that is, that you have to sit on a special place. Because it's not so easy to move it to another to another location. You have it on your desktop and it has a lot of cables and maybe a writer and a scanner and so forth. But I look forward to these edits. Maybe this is like therapy, this recording session you're watching right now to me. Maybe it's important for forgetting about these feelings and this mood that I so want to leave. That's why I decided to record, and I'm really not sure if I'm gonna do, if I'm gonna post this. It's quite like a diary, you know. Maybe it's just for me. This is how long I have read in this book. I stopped reading it. My stomach again. I stopped reading it about a month ago. For no reason. Or if it was because I started to work again on this job. I guess it's quite obvious that I have nothing to complain about, really. But still, I do. actually just leave sometimes. And you just feel negativity. I'm really hungry now. I haven't been to the grocery store. Actually had some ginger in the cake. And that was good. When you not want to go out shopping, I mean getting food, it kind of makes you improvise from what you have at home in the freezer. Realized it's because you have to take a lot of decisions. Every edit you have decided to do, well, that's the first decision, but then you have to take a decision how to do it, and you have to be creative, find a solution for the problem. Those days will come, even if you don't think so at the moment. The dips are always dips, and there will be a day when they turn into tops for everyone. A roller coaster, I guess. So I think I leave this bed now and take a shower and put on some clothes and walk, go out for a walk. 15 minutes walk. You don't need to listen to this anymore. Sorry for being so super.